It's one of the cornerstones of John Howard's legacy as Prime Minister, brave and strict new gun laws in the wake of the Port Arthur massacre. But now we learn that Australians own just as many guns now as we did back then. So did it really work? Ms. Zoe Ford has been asking the question.
It was the biggest gun buyback the modern world had seen, and so controversial, a newly elected John Howard wore a bulletproof vest after announcing it.
It will add to the overall safety and good of the Australian community.
Australians owned 3.2 million firearms in 1996. In the wake of the Port Arthur massacre, 700,000 automatic and semi-automatic weapons were melted down. But 16 years on, new research shows we've rearmed.
We now have roughly the same number of firearms in private hands in Australia as we had prior to Port Arthur.
It's too soon to know what impact that'll have, but Professor Alpers insists the buyback wasn't a failure.
Since the laws were passed after Port Arthur, the risk of dying by gunshot in Australia has dropped by half, and it stayed there.
Australia's population has, of course, risen since Port Arthur, and with it, legal gun ownership has jumped too.
Australia is one of the safest countries in the world when it comes to guns. For the number of guns we have, people are very, very responsible.
The problem lies with criminals who are not, and momentum is growing to do more about them.
We should be moving now on handguns. There is absolutely no need for anyone in the community to have handguns.
It is high time that the state and territory governments put aside their differences and united behind a national firearms register.
Currently, each state keeps a separate incompatible database. Ms. Zoe Ford, 10 News.